They just beat her up really bad. And I think it was just appalling. That's all they could come up with. And the main thing they did this for is so they could get TV.
I'm not going to dispute what you said, because I think he described it accurately, but you know, that doesn't apply to me or you, or if you didn't hear.
Well, you're part, excuse me.
Durbin complimented me.
Excuse me. You are the head of the Senate. You're the oldest person there. You've been there 50 years. I mean, it's unbelievable what you've done for Iowa in the past. I have voted for you in the past. And now it's getting to the time where I think you're not for the people, you're more for the party.
So that right there was a voter at just a couple of weeks ago, one of these local town halls with Senator Chuck Grassley. Really laying into them over the way that the Republicans have handled the nomination hearings for Ketanji Brown Jackson. Obviously, we've done a lot of coverage of it. You're probably familiar with the threat of QAnon bait that's gone through it. Insane attacks over the definition of women and critical race theory. Basically, the stuff that the Republicans are interested in that doesn't necessarily have anything to do with Ketanji Brown Jackson, her history, or what position she would hold on the court. But they just wanted to make it about that. And it turns out it's frustrated a lot of people, including many Republicans, and polls back up what you saw in that video. More than half, 52% of respondents disapproved of how Republican senators handled the process. About half, just exactly half that number actually approved of it. And these, like, you might think, well, yeah, but people are mad about Congress all the time. They don't like anything that they do. What does that really say? Well, those numbers are the reverse of how people viewed senators' handling of the Brett Kavanaugh confirmation hearings. They weren't nearly as bothered by the way those were handled, even though they were insane, because people felt, rightfully so, that it was justified that people were asking hard questions of the beer guy. Whereas the attacks against Ketanji Brown Jackson have been seen as a little bit more deranged. Dan, what do you think about this?
I'm actually really surprised. I mean, as always, the numbers are way too low of people who should really be upset of how Republicans handled this overall process. Like, I think that the way they try to paint Ketanji Brown Jackson as someone who, even though she's very qualified, even though she's come from a judicial path that is very, would bring a very fresh perspective to the court. Needless to say that she'd be the first African-American woman to be on the court, but the fact that they tried to tie her to pedophilia and QAnon conspiracy theories, the fact they tried to tie her to being tough on crime, it was one of the more shameful displays in politics I've seen in a while. And we just went through the Trump administration, yeah. So that's saying quite a lot. But you know, there's no way that Republicans won't go rhetorically to try to capture power. And of course, they're going to go after fear and fear mongering. That's what they're doing against LGBTQ plus people right now all across the country. That's what they've been doing against people of color for years and continue to do all across the country. So this was just, the Supreme Court hearing was just another case of that. I'm glad that a lot of Republicans are seeing through that, but it really should be more.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, although look, I think you understand this, the way that there's so much tribalism, so much partisanship, 52, kind of high, honestly. Like if you get them down to 27, like they're usually in the 30 to 40 range for whatever weird BS you want to peddle. But yeah, I agree. I mean, it was like, what more could they have done to make a mockery of this process of the Supreme Court, especially considering the clear hypocrisy in a number of different ways that they have approached Democratic nominees and supported their own nominees over the past few years with Amy Coney Barrett and blocking Merrick Garland and all that. I think people rightfully see this as a politicized process, but not a both sides politicized process. It is not the same on both sides. And the Republicans have found themselves, I think, in a little bit of a difficult position, whether they can identify it or not. There is clearly a difference in their strategy, which is to appeal to their committed base. So you have Ketanji Brown Jackson, who is indisputably qualified for the Supreme Court, historic first black woman nominated to the Supreme Court. They have to destroy her, because their base wants that. They don't want women on the Supreme Court. They certainly don't want liberal women. They don't want black women or black people on the Supreme Court. They love watching Republicans just shower her with disdain and conspiracy theories and all that. So they're delivering. They understand what their base wants and they're providing it. But for regular people, That's not what they want at all. That is obviously too far in a number of different ways. And the Republicans do need to placate their base, but there's also a midterm election that there's every reason to believe they're gonna do very well in. Why needlessly shoot yourself in the foot with a bunch of people who might be really bothered by the lack of action by the Democrats and Joe Biden over the past couple of years? They might be thinking, well, you know, we gave them a try, but they're not really doing much. Maybe we go back to the Republicans. And the Republicans remind them of how insane that idea is. It's just, it's a weird strategy considering the stakes here.
Yeah, I'm really concerned with the Democrats and how they totally handled that process at all. We all know, you and I watching politics for a while, John, we know that these are inherently political events. These are just political theater. You're trying to find the best soundbite so that your side, Fox or MSNBC or increasingly more so CNN, can just play that on end and on end. And really the only person who used it was Cory Booker to do his own sort of performance that wasn't really hitting on or like going on offense against Republicans, but was sort of, you know, just making a historical moment, which of course Cory Booker fumbling every single time. But overall, I'm really concerned with how things look for the midterm elections, especially. Democrats need to, I mean, I think Joe Biden is going to say, look, I promised a black woman would be on the Supreme Court and I did that. Enough, right? Mm-hmm. And it's gonna be one of those you ain't black moments for a lot of African Americans, because as we'll get into in other stories in the future, there are so many other things that black people are concerned about that having a Supreme Court justice, it's like we've had it with the sort of, I guess we've had it with just the performative social justice politics. We mm-hmm. need actual things that will help people.
Exactly. Yeah. One promise kept is not necessarily enough. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.